A 51-year-old female has a hard lump underneath her tongue and pain while eating. Check out the full workup and surgery today on the Open Reduction. Welcome to the Open Reduction, your channel covering all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten, and today we're talking about a lesion in the floor of the mouth that is giving this patient a lot of trouble. This patient is a 51-year-old female who's felt a lump underneath her tongue for years. It was never a problem until recently when she started to develop pain while eating. She went to her dentist, who felt the lump in the floor of her mouth and subsequently sent her to my office for treatment. On exam, the right floor of the mouth is slightly elevated compared to the left. The salivary duct, Wharton's duct, is patent, but there's minimal output. Also, when I stimulate the right submandibular gland, it is tender. The left gland and duct are working normally. I'm also able to feel a hard mass in the right floor of her mouth. It is mobile and non-tender to touch. I take a cone beam CT, and here's what I see. There is a radiopaque mass in the right floor of mouth, medial to the mandible. It is well-defined and measures about 8 millimeters in length. This workup points to the diagnosis of a salivary stone, or a sialolith. This sialolith forms due to mineral deposits that accumulate in the duct that empties the submandibular gland. The saliva has a mineral component, and when a nidus causes some of these minerals to congeal, there is a snowball effect and the stone keeps going with time. Patients who have a dry mouth and low salivary flow are more likely to develop sialoliths. Wharton's duct is a common location for sialoliths because the duct is long and it travels superiorly. The treatment for this is to expose and remove the stone. This case is done in the office under local anesthesia. Once the area is numb, I make an incision in the floor of the mouth right where I feel the stone. It is so important to keep my finger proximal to the stone so it doesn't fall deeper into the duct while I'm trying to remove it. Now I use a hemostat to dissect into the floor of the mouth and around the sialolith. I use a 15 blade to free the duct directly over the sialolith. I can see it coming into view here. Finally, I tease it out with a periosteal elevator. I check the patency of the duct by stimulating the gland. There is a healthy amount of flowing mucinous saliva. I leave this area open intentionally. I want the duct to remain flowing while this heals. I instruct patients to drink a lot of water and also to use salivary stimulants regularly, like lemon candy. Eventually, the duct will form a new opening proximal to the original opening, and the gland will drain from there. Thanks so much for watching. Please click those like and subscribe buttons and check out my channel for additional oral and maxillofacial surgical content. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten. I'll catch you next time on the Open Reduction.